What I've learned, a leader is someone who leads by example. A leader doesn't turn a corner and fear what might be next. A leader is someone who's in command of their game. He's not afraid of doing the right thing. And not afraid to fly with the best of them. Being captain of the St. Louis Blues is something I wanted since I, you know, became a member of the team. You always think of the captain as the leader and someone who can, you know, who's got a lot of, you know, influence on the team. And for me, it's a very prideful thing. When I'm flying, there's so much to like. It's a feeling where you're free, you're in control of what you're doing, and your mind has to be totally consumed with what's coming next in the plane, staying ahead of the next task, or else you fall behind, you're distracted and something catastrophic can happen. And for me, that's really relieving to block out all the other things that are on my mind, the day's activities, the world of hockey that I was in. Basically, when I'm checking out the plane, it's called a pre-flight. I'm making sure that all the control surfaces are operational, that there's all the fluids in the plane so it runs, and that all the electronics are working so that we can use those while we're up in the air as well. You don't want anything to go wrong. Anything you can, you know, diagnose while you're on the ground is a lot better than diagnosing it while you're in the air. Weather's marginal today. There's ceilings are about 2,200 feet above the ground, which is flyable, but it's, if we're going long distances, it's not real safe, because if you do have engine failure or something like that, you don't have a lot of time to decide where you're going to try to glide down to the ground and land. Today, we took a brief little flight, took off from Spirit of St. Louis Airport, flew to the west about 12 miles to Washington, Missouri, did a little loop in the pattern, did a low approach there.
Initially, my grandfather was a gunner in World War II. My wife's grandfather flew float planes in Minnesota for his whole life, so flying's kind of been in my blood, and something I always wanted to take up, just didn't think it was in my capabilities.
Something's always creeping into my mind, but when I'm flying, it's all about what's going on in that plane, and that's a real relief for me. After we went for our brief little flight, we headed to my house and had a meal cooked by my wife and I, and little Brussels sprouts with mushrooms and garlic. We've got some New York strip steaks. Kelly's a vegetarian, so the meat's just for me.
Marty, come here, hon.
We've got four rescued dogs and two rescued cats, so it keeps us busy, but they're, you know, they give and receive love and, you know, really keep us grounded. And similar to flying, when you come home to dogs and cats that don't care if you had a good game or a bad game, or, you know, took a dumb penalty or whatever it may be, it's just, you know, they're like nothing else for us. Athletes for Animals, we try to pair athletes that are passionate about their own pets, passionate about the lives of animals in general, companion animals, with local organizations that are doing great work for the animal welfare community. And we've had a great response so far from athletes in football, baseball, hockey, willing to put their names out there and leverage the platform that they have for the betterment of the lives of so many animals. My wife Kelly and I get involved with animal rescue because they're innocent beings that need a voice. They have no voice and they need someone to stand up for them. And we feel a compassion for them, as we've seen the resiliency and the ability to be persistent and work through some of the misgivings that people have given to them.
horses have been involved with 5 Acres for over 4 years now, and they were part of the capital campaign and really instrumental in us raising awareness and raising the funds to build this new building. And part of their contribution went to the naming rights on the meet and greet room.
To have someone walk by your side, you know, with no ulterior motives, with no other things on their mind other than, you know, trying to serve you and be your best friend, what more pure love can you ask for something? And that's what animals give you every single day. What I've learned, a leader is someone who leads by example. A leader is ready to fly and lead their team into the next fight. He's not afraid of doing the right thing, and not afraid of seeing what's beyond.